Hello there, friends. Good afternoon to all. Hope you guys can hear me. Today is a beautiful Saturday, right? It's on April 24th, right? I hope you guys can hear me. Yes, I can hear myself when I hear it from my phone, which means that everything is okay, right? First of all, thank you so much for joining me. For those of you who are listening, thank you for joining, and I will be appreciating. I would really appreciate it if you guys can help me to share this video to your profile so that more people can benefit from today's talk. If you look at today's talk, right, who should save gold? I mean, the title is like so cliche. You must be thinking, Naresh, I mean, isn't it obvious, right? Who should save gold? Everybody, right? Everybody should save gold. But really, is everybody doing it, right? So some of you might be even thinking whether is it something suitable for you, or is gold again something that is useful at this time and age? Because gold is something that we've been talking for hundreds of years. Okay, it's not like a cryptocurrency or any hyped up asset, right? But gold is an asset that is very boring, something that everybody knows. And I don't really have to explain further how does gold work, right? Because it's something that everybody knows, right? So here, coming back to whether should everybody save gold or who should save gold, I would say, again, it depends on the kind of profile, the kind of your own characteristics, okay? So that is why we are going to dive further today, where we are going to look at who should be ideally save gold to help them in strengthening their financial portfolio. So that is what we are going to do today. So without further ado, thank you so much for joining. For those of you who just joined, help me to share this video so that more people can benefit. You can like this video also to just to give a like, so that more people can see this and can benefit from this session as well. So as you listen along to this session, if you have any questions, you can always drop them in the comment section and I will address them accordingly, right? So without further ado, let's go into the slide. Right, so I hope you can see my slide. Okay, okay, so you can see my slide. So before I begin, just a quick reminder that I'm not an investment expert. Rather, what I'm doing today is just sharing on what I have seen for the past 2 years or so in my journey to protect my hard-earned money. Okay, because just like you, I'm also earning a particular amount of money, and then I realized that keeping the money in the form of cash would somehow is not actually helping me. Okay, it's not actually helping me in my journey to save money. So what I did, I need to save this money into another form, right? So as I explore the options, I was looking into different options. So in my financial portfolio, I have a couple of tools. Okay, so basically, we are just looking for tools to protect our money, right? So among all the tools that I have in my financial portfolio, I also explore gold. So gold, as I was looking for ways on to save in the form of gold, I came across public gold. And that's when I gave it a try. And then I realized that this method really worked. Okay, so therefore, instead of just keeping this knowledge to myself, I decided to spread this knowledge to more people, so that this is not something that only a selected number of people should benefit, right? But rather, this is something that everybody should know and should take advantage of, okay? Because even schools should look at this as a curriculum where they should teach their school kids, right? Teach the school going kids on how to save money using assets, and basically to teach them financial literacy, Okay, so I hope the educators out there can start looking into this as curriculum and see whether can we improve the upcoming generation in terms of the financial literacy, right? Okay, why am I not able to go to the next slide? Okay, now I can. So if you look at the next slide over here, right, this is some of the things that I shared a couple of days back, where I was looking at the poverty level income, where I was reading about this, and I saw that I was quite shocked to read this news whereby they have revised the ministry has revised the poverty level income from 980, which was the benchmark set in 2005. They revised this level from 980 to 2,208 ringgit. So what does this mean, right? What does this information mean? It simply means if a particular household, okay, if a particular household, a family, if they are earning 2,208 ringgit and below, again, if they earn 2,208 below, what happened is that this family is considered under the poverty level, right? So if they are under poverty level, what does it mean for a regular person like us? That means that our hard-earned money is no longer being is no longer valuable. Okay, it's no longer valuable simply because if you think about it, right, in 2005, a typical family can survive with 980 ringgit. Today, the same family, if they want to live a very modest life, a very on the border lifestyle, they need 2,208 ringgit, right? So you can see that the price jump is quite big. It's more than two times, but in order to enjoy the similar lifestyle, it's quite saddening to see this. But at the same time, this further strengthens the need for financial literacy, like I mentioned earlier, right? So that's why I thought that this effort that I am putting, or the efforts that we can see a lot of us are doing, where we want to share the experience in saving in the form of gold and how people can protect their hard-earned money using assets that appreciates over time. So the efforts that are being put by these educators, by these gurus, right, like Robert Kiyosaki and all that, it's really needed at this point of time, because it's not like all of us know what to do with our money. And for some weird reason, money is a topic that not many people talk about. I, again, do not understand why. This topic is very important, very crucial, that all our children should know about this. The basics of money, at least, for example, like the difference between asset versus liability, the difference between credit versus debit. So this is very important information that our children should know, right? So that's the information that I saw a couple of days back, and I posted on my Facebook page. So if you guys want to know more information, you guys can take a look at it. And then, this is one thing. And then I also wanted to share with you another thing which I saw this morning, which was posted by my goal mentor, who is Tuan Zul. So basically, you can see he posted that 7 years ago, okay, because in Facebook, if you notice, they have this feature where you can share the memory which took place like a couple of years ago, right? So exactly today, right, April 24th, 2014, Tuan Zul, he posted on his Facebook that 1 gram of gold is 146 ringgit, right? And at that time, not many people joined public gold. Not many people save gold, and not many people invest in gold, right? And because the reason at that time, or the argument at the time, is that the gold price is at all-time high. It's very expensive. Therefore, saving in the form of gold is not relevant. It's not a good idea. Okay, so that's why I took a screenshot of that and I put it on the left side. But then take a look at the right side. If you look at the screenshot on the right side, that's basically the price, the gold price today. Okay, if you look at the screenshot, I just took it like about 45 minutes ago. If you look at it, 1 gram of gold today is worth 257. Right? So 7 years ago, 1 gram of gold was worth 146. Today, 1 gram of gold is worth 257. So let's say for some weird reason, 7 years ago, some people were stupid enough. Some people were dumb enough to buy gold. Right? They buy gold, and then today, if you talk to them, they say, "Hey, Naresh, 7 years ago, you bought gold for 146 ringgit. Today, do you think you lose money? Do you lose money by saving gold?" Okay, what do you think the answer is? The answer is no. There is no money losing. Okay, but then let's see if you follow up that question. Do you regret buying gold 7 years ago? Right? So the answer I will give is that, yes, I regretted not buying more. Right? I regretted not buying more gold, because if I buy more gold, today I'm actually getting more profit. Right? So for those of you out there who are still thinking whether is gold a good tool to put in my financial portfolio, or is it good to save in the form of gold, just look at this. Are you going to wait 7 years down the road before you make the decision? Or are you going to start? Just start a little. Right? Just start a little and see how does the growth looks like in the next 7 years. Okay, so that's why I thought this screenshot is interesting for me to share with you guys today, because there are some of you who are still in still contemplating, right? Still thinking whether is it something good, or how if it's not going to work out, right? Look at this, right? Do your own research, do your own reading, then you will find out how useful gold can be as part of your financial portfolio. Okay. So now let's go into the agenda today. So today I'm going to just go through a very quick one. Introduction, basically just to share with you how I come across this public goal and how I benefit along the way. And we're going to dive into the content of today. And also finally, if there are any Q&A, you can always put it in the comment section and I'll be able to address them. Okay, so far there is no Q&A. For those who just joined me, thank you so much for joining. I will really appreciate it if you can like the video and help me to share. Okay, so that more people can benefit from this session. Okay, so I got to know about this public goal in the year 2019 after reading this book, okay, Misi Bebas Hutang. Okay, so after reading this book, I got even more interested, and then I bought the other book, if you can see behind me, which is called Wang Emas. So after reading that book, that's when I got to know about public goal. Then I started my gap program, and at the same time I started buying gold bars like this. Okay, I started buying gold bars like this, and I realized that along these years, right, from 2019, 2020, 2021, I realized that the savings that I converted in the form of gold has been protected and it appreciated, right? So for example, the gold bar that I bought here, the 10 gram gold bar, I bought it for 1,800 ringgit, and today the same gold bar is now worth 2,500 ringgit, okay? So the money that I converted 2 years ago in the form of gold like this, today, not only that money is protected, but the money value has grown. Do you see the point I'm trying to make over here? So that's when I realized that this gold is very good to protect the value of our money, and is something that everybody can do. And therefore, I started to share this information across the social platform, including YouTube, Telegram, Facebook, even like this, right? Even the Facebook Live that I'm doing, all these are my efforts to create awareness regarding gold savings. And I hope more people are more aware of this method and start taking action. Okay. So with that said, let's start into the first group of people who need to save gold. So this is very important, because the concept of emergency fund is something that I think people have heard about it, but they do not know exactly what is it about, right? So emergency fund, as the name implies, is the fund that you use it for uncertainty. Okay, that you don't really need it urgent, that you don't really need it in the short term, But for, let's say if something out of the ordinary happens, okay, when things out of ordinary happens, you need some form of fund to help you, right? So that's where this emergency fund comes in the picture and help you. Okay, so emergency fund is useful to weather during uncertainties, for example, like a retrenchment or even like the pandemic we are facing right now, right, like COVID. So if there is a pandemic like this, you need to have a sort of a protection. So that's where emergency fund comes in the picture in order to help you. And usually, okay, according to the financial experts out there, emergency fund is usually needed to cover 3 to 6 months of your monthly commitment. Okay. And here, you can mix this emergency fund in between cash and gold. Okay, usually cash is more better because at least you can use it to pay bills immediately and things like that. But then let's say if you keep in the form of, let's say if you choose 3 months in order to allocate for your emergency fund, you can choose to have 1.5 months commitment in the form of cash, whereas the other 1.5 months commitment in the form of gold. Right, because during bad times, usually the gold price will shoot up, and at that time when you sell your gold, you are actually getting more money, right? And so some people might ask, so Naresh, you asked me to, or you are suggesting that I can save my emergency fund in the form of gold, but then during bad times, how can I quickly sell this gold bar and get my money, right? So this is where you can make use of the Ahrano institution that I spoke about a couple of times before. Where basically what you can do, you can go to this institution and you can pledge this gold, right? You can pledge this gold and you can get a very good return. You can get a very high value of money by pledging your gold at this institution. And usually they will give a duration of time where in this duration of time, you can roll back this money and then you can then pay back to the institution and collect your gold bar. So, for example, let's say if you have a gold bar like this, right? So, like I said, today the gold bar is worth 2,500 ringgit. So, you just bring along this gold bar to the Aranda institution. And usually, because public gold has become so famous, most of the Aranda institution, they know public gold so well. So, they by looking at the public gold bar, they will do some testing to check the weight, the purity. And then they will give you a particular amount of money based on the current price of this gold bar. But they have some calculation, okay? They have some calculation, they have some formulas to it. But comparing to other institutions out there, our institution gives a better rate, okay? So this is where you can actually make use of your gold bar during the uncertainty times, okay? So earlier on, I was talking about this promotion, right? I was telling about how there are exciting promotions available as of now. And again, I'm just going to repeat again the promotion that I spoke earlier, where until tomorrow, there is a very limited time promotion, which is expiring tomorrow, where for new customers or for new clients who join Public Gold, and also if you commit to do or if you commit to buy a gold coin, a dinar, okay, I have a half dinar, okay, half dinar, but then if you commit a one dinar, which is exactly 4.25 gram of gold, which is a 999 quality, and it's 24 karat gold. If you choose to do this installment plan for 10 times, meaning every month your commitment will be about 109 ringgit, 110 ringgit. Okay, so just by committing yourself 110 ringgit per month and just make this payment for 10 months, so after 10 months, you will get this gold coin in your hands. Okay, so basically not just you converting your cash in the form of gold at a very affordable rate, after the 10 months, right, you're going to collect your gold coin. And by doing so, you are entitled for the welcoming gift, which is a gold folder. Okay, which is a gold folder like this. Okay, and this gold folder is worth 15 ringgit. Right? So Naresh, this is the same thing that you spoke last week. What is the extra thing? Because I remember yesterday you mentioned that I'm going to offer something that is difficult for me to say no. Okay, so what is it? All right. So yeah, this is what I'm going to talk about. So for those of you, okay, for new clients and also existing clients, if you choose to take up this promotion, right, where you want to commit yourself this one dinar, and you choose to do the installment, right? I'm going to give you a 10 ringgit cashback. Okay, I'm going to give back a 10 ringgit cashback, which means the dinner that you are going to purchase today will be discount 10%, because not 10% will be discount 10 ringgit. Okay, we'll discount 10 ringgit because I'm going to top up the 10 ringgit for you, right? So this is something that I'm doing out of my own pocket, right? Therefore, I'm only offering this to the next 10 clients only, right? So for the new clients, you get to get the dinar, you get to get the installment plan for 10 months, you will get the gold folder, and on top of that, I'm going to give my personal cashback 10 ringgit. For existing clients, since you're already a client, so for you to get that gold folder will no longer eligible, but my personal guarantee is that you can continue doing the installment for the dinar, and I will give you the 10 ringgit cashback, okay? So similarly, if you do 2 pieces, I will give you 20 ringgit cashback. If you commit 3 pieces, I will give you 30 ringgit cashback. Okay, so this is the additional promotion that I'm offering for people out there, including non-clients versus already clients. Okay, meaning I'm offering this to everybody out there who haven't joined as my client, and also those who already joined me as client. Okay, and how about people with a bigger budget? Okay, so with a bigger budget, we have this 10 gram gold bar. Okay, like what I showed you here, right? Okay, this is a 10 gram gold bar where the monthly installment will be about 257, 258. That kind of is within that range. Okay, it's about 260 ringgit, that range, right? So again, what you can do for new clients, you will be entitled to do this installment for 10 months. And at the same time, you will be eligible to collect this gold folder. And at the same time, what I will give is that I will give each piece 20 ringgit cashback. Okay? I will give you guys 20 ringgit cashback, which means the 10 gram gold bar that you are committing will have a discount of 20 ringgit. Okay? And if you are a new client, you will get a free gold folder. Right? And for existing clients, what you can get, you will, since you're already a client, so you won't get this gold folder, but you can enjoy the installment plan, the 10 months installment plan. At the same time, my personal guarantee is that the cashback. For one piece, I will give you 20 ringgit cashback. For two pieces, I'm giving you 40 ringgit cashback. And for three pieces, I'm giving you 60 ringgit cashback. Okay? And again, this only applicable for 10 clients only. Because this cashback, I'm using my own money. Therefore, I cannot do this for a lot of you. Okay, only a selected people who take action today. Okay, a lot of you who are just becoming a silent viewer, a silent reader, I think it's time for you to take action. Okay, because are you going to wait for the next 7 years just to know that you missed the ride? I don't think so. That is a good strategy to use. Rather, you take action. Okay, you start small. Basically, I'm not asking you to buy 10,000 ringgit worth of gold, right? It's just 100 ringgit or maybe 260 ringgit per month. Okay, so for those of you who take action, you are getting cash back. For new clients, you are getting the gold folder. Okay, and by joining me, right, by joining under my guidance, I will keep sharing with you more information about gold savings, about gold investments, and then if there are any opportunities, okay, let's say if suddenly the gold price drops, okay, because I'm keeping track of all this price volatility, I will immediately tell to my clients that they can take advantage of this opportunity, basically, right? So if you join me, I will have all these features embedded if you join my team, okay? So there is the promotion that I'm going to share with you, where the same promotion is going to expire tomorrow, okay? So after tomorrow, if you want to do the 10 times installment, and then if you want to get that free gold card, right, it's no longer applicable. So for those of you who are still thinking, right, I think it's time to take action already. Okay, it's time to take action already. So for those of you who want to take action, contact me. I have pasted my WhatsApp link at the comment section. Just click on that link and contact me and tell me, Naresh, I want to take the dinar promotion, right? Then I will help you accordingly. Okay, so yeah, let's go into the second category of people who need to save gold. Okay, so this group of people, they know the importance of saving. Okay, so we try ourselves, we try our best. Okay, we try our best to save money, but then for some reason, the money goes missing. The money disappears from our bank account. Okay, so the reason why I include this in this session, in this slide, is because once upon a time, I'm also in this category. Okay, so I remember I used to tell you guys that when I was studying back then, I used to work as a waiter during the weekends, and I also worked as a tutor in a tuition center. The money that I earned from there, I used to keep it in the bank. Okay, and I thought I'm doing a great job because I'm keeping it in the bank. Right, all of us were taught from little that whenever you have money, where do you keep? You keep in the bank. So that's exactly what I did. But then when you keep money in the bank, for some reason you will tend to use it for some expenses. Okay, so even now I don't remember why did I spend it for, because it's actually not an important thing. Okay, let's say if I use that money to buy an asset, I will remember, right? But the fact that I cannot remember what I used that money for shows that I have spent that money on something not important. Okay, and this is also actually can be a strategy where and I also, I mean, being we Malaysians are very kind-hearted people. So when you have friends coming over and say, "Hey, Naresh, I'm having this problem lah," and then they tell them and they tell you all the sad story, and finally they'll ask, "Can you borrow me some money lah? I'll promise I'll pay you back next month," right? So I mean, being a friend, being a good friend, what do you do? You lend them the money, right? But then what happened? The money never comes back. Okay, not all my friends are like that, but there are some friends who borrowed money from me and until today they haven't returned it back. Okay, so this is where I think where gold can be a good strategy, where the extra cash that you have, right, instead of keeping in the bank, why don't we convert in the gap account? Okay, if you keep it in gap account, basically you convert in the form of gold. So when your friends come over and they say, "Hey, Naresh," and then they tell you the sad story, right? You can say, "Bro, actually, I understand your situation. I really want to help you, but unfortunately, my cash is not with me lah. I have very limited cash which I need to pay my bills, and extra cash I kept it in gold. So when I keep in the form of gold, it's very difficult to sell." So when you tell your side of the story, which is very difficult for you to sell, then they won't push you anymore, right? So by having a gold allocation, okay, by having your savings in the form of gold, it can actually help you it will help you to prevent these weird situations, right? And this is where the gold accumulation program can be an excellent program for this purpose. Because the budget required for these kind of things, for this program, is very minimal, and it's something that everybody can do. Okay, so again, let me just briefly tell you what are the benefits of having a gold accumulation program. Where in order to start this, right, you only need 100 ringgit, and every savings or every deposit that you make are being backed by physical gold, and the registration is free. And then is this something that you have to do monthly basis, right? Is this a monthly commitment, compulsory thing? The answer is no. You can do it as and when you have budget. And then is there any safekeeping fee? Is there any annual fee or any sales charge, right? The answer is no, right? So it's a very cost effective way to convert your hard-earned money in the form of asset that will appreciate over time. Okay, so for the parents out there also, they can open a gap account, which is known as junior account, for your children. Whereas if you have some cash that you want to keep for your children, right, let's say if they have some now with the Ramadan, and then you have the Hari Raya and all that, so your children might be receiving some ampo money, right? So this ampo money, instead of keeping in the bank, you can consider converting some of them in the form of gold or in the gap account and just keep it grow over there, right? So this is where the this gap account can be very useful. And the reason why I also wanted to tell this to a lot of people out there is simply because that this is the asset, right? Gold is an asset that first of all, we know that it appreciates over time. Okay, because remember I told you that in the year 1990s, 1 kg of gold is worth 30,000 ringgit, right? And today, 1 kg of gold is 240,000 ringgit. So we know that over the long term, the gold price will always go up. Okay, so this is, but you can say, but Naresh, property also same thing, right? I can also invest in property and along the long term, the price will appreciate and I can still make money, right? Yes, you are right. You can also do that with property. But then with property, the asset is very complicated. Can you start investing in property with 100 ringgit? No. Okay, let's say, for example, you found this property, right? You found this property. Let's say the price of this property is 800,000 ringgit. Okay, 800,000 ringgit. And then you do some calculation and then you see, you think that this property, when you buy and then when you rent it out, you get that cash flow. Okay, you basically, rich dad, poor dad. And then you thought you want to play the Robert Kiyosaki's game, where you want to use property to generate cash flow, right? Amazing, awesome. So now you found this property worth 800,000 ringgit. And then now next thing you want to do, do you have that 800,000 ringgit in hand? The answer is no. Therefore, what you need to do, you need to apply for a loan. When you apply for a loan, the bank won't simply, oh, welcome Naresh, I've been waiting for you. Nah, please take 800,000 ringgit. No, right? The bank will look at your profile. They will see whether are you a good paymaster? How many credit cards do you have? Is your CTOS record clean? Is your Secris record clean? Then they will look at my profile. Oh, Naresh, you have 2 credit cards and then you haven't been paying your credit card properly for the past 6 months. So if this is the profile, your financial profile, as a bank, I'm actually not comfortable in loaning you the 800,000 ringgit, right? So if that is the case, how are you going to now materialize this dream of earning cash flow? Basically, the dream is just gone, correct? But with gold, okay, with gold like this, right? Even if I'm declared as a bankrupt person, okay, for some reason I did some very stupid thing and then I got declared bankrupt. If I got declared bankrupt, can I still buy gold and keep it for myself? The answer is yes, you can. Right, so this is the asset that will appreciate over time, but doesn't require any complicated paperwork, doesn't require any like a CTOS la, CCRIS la, and all that. Okay, so that's why I think this is something that everybody can do. And CAP program allows you to start with 100 ringgit already. Okay, there is no registration fee, there is no sales charge, there is no safekeeping fee, so it's the most cost effective way to save money in the form of gold. All right, so I hope I have explained myself accordingly here. And then let's go into the third category. Who need to save gold? Okay, so this is something that everybody can relate. Okay, so the reason why I put here also, because I'm also a victim of this scenario where if you look at the creative advertising in our online platform, right, they came up with so many terms, anniversary sale, they call it double digit sale, 10-10, 11-11, 12-12. They come up with all these weird terms. They came up with all these creative terms just to entice people, okay, just to induce people to start making impulse purchases, right? And they will show you this pair of shoe that you saw like sometime back. And then they tell you, hey, Naresh, remember this pair of shoe? Now this shoe has only got 3 units left. And if you buy in the next 10 minutes, I will give you 20% discount. All right. So when you see these kind of advertisements, most of the time what happens is that you will tend to buy. Okay, you will, because they will put you in a situation that you have to do it fast. Right? When you have to do it fast, you tend to make the spending, you tend to swipe your credit card or anything. But then that's when you realize that actually you are working from home. Since you are working from home, you don't really need that pair of shoes. Right, so most of the time we only start thinking about this after we make the purchase. Right, so when this, how it happens, when we fall into this trap, that's why I call it, we fall into this trap. Okay, because most of the time the things that we buy are not urgently required actually. they are not urgently required, but for some reason we buy it. Okay, so when this happens, our savings plan, okay, we must be thinking that, okay, this month I want to save 200 ringgit, 200 ringgit and all that. But because of us doing this impulse purchase, that savings plan has got disrupted. Okay, so how to overcome this? Right, so how to overcome this issue is where I want to introduce this concept called pay yourself first. Okay, so actually this concept, I learned it from this book, lah. Okay, from Rich Dad Poor Dad. I read this concept where the idea here is that you, because what happened here, right? What happened, typically what happened is that we work so hard, we earn our money, we earn our salary, right? And once we get the salary, we use the salary to pay other people. When I say pay other people, it can be your mortgage, it can be your car loan, it can be your credit card, it can be the personal loan, right? So you earn so hard, you collect that money, you earn that salary, but then you pay other people. Okay? But then this is where Robert Kiyosaki came up with this concept called pay yourself first. Actually, this concept was first introduced in the book The Richest Man in Babylon. If you have time, you can read. You can find that book and you can read it. It's a very interesting book. It's a book that I think should be incorporated in the school literature. Okay, where instead of studying the literature of Shakespeare, for example, maybe they can introduce this as part of the literature, because not only you will study the literature, but at the same time you will have financial literacy as well. Okay, but okay, putting that aside, so the concept of pay yourself first is, once you get that money, your salary, you have quickly allocate a portion of that money for your future. Okay, when you allocate some money for your future, that is paying yourself effectively. Okay, so here what you can do, you get your salary, take 10% of your salary, convert in the form of gold. When you convert in the form of gold, what happens is that, first of all, you are saving for future. And second of all, for you to make that impulse purchases, is no longer on the chance of you making that impulse purchase will reduce drastically. Okay, because the reason why we are able to make that impulse purchase is that we know that we have some money in the bank in the first place. Right, because you know you've been saving 200 ringgit for 3 months, and then on your mind you'll be thinking, okay, I have about 600 ringgit, so that pair of shoe is a limited edition shoe, is worth 400 ringgit. Okay, I think I can buy. Therefore, you make that impulse purchase. But let's say if you convert that 200 ringgit every month in the form of Gap account, in the form of gold, so even though you saw that pair of shoe, limited edition, it's 400 ringgit, but then you think, oh, but then I have 600 ringgit in Gap account, and it's quite troublesome for me to withdraw that Gap account just to buy this pair of shoe. Okay, maybe I'll wait for next time. Okay, so do you see how by converting your savings in the form of gold essentially helps you to save money? So this is where the powerful concept of paying yourself first can help you. Okay, so maybe some of you are listening to this concept for the first time. Let me just briefly go through what does the pay yourself concept works. And if you look at the picture on the left side, right, so that is the typical way of how we are doing. Okay, and in the Rich Dad Poor Dad book also, Robert Kiyosaki calls this the rat race, simply because if you have rat, or if you have seen rat in a cage, right, rat or mice, basically what they do is that they will, if you notice, there is a wheel in that cage, and you can see that the mice or rat will just keep on running. Okay, you can see they are doing a lot of work, right? They are running, but then they are actually not going anywhere. All right, the rat or mice is running so hard, but they are not going anywhere, which is very similar to what we are doing. We work so hard, we do overtime, we earn money. But then after we earn money, what happened? We pay everybody else and then we continue running again. Right? We continue running again, and then once we get the salary, we repeat this process again and again. And end of the day, when you look back, what are the assets that you have? Zero. You have the you pay off that personal loan, you pay off that credit card loan, and all these loans have high interest, right? If you don't pay, they will charge you more interest. So in order to save yourself from paying more interest, you tend to pay off that loan month after month. All right, so this is where we need to change our concept. we have to think again on how to use or how to integrate this concept of pay yourself first into our financial portfolio. Okay, so if you look at the picture on the right side, the picture on the right side, basically, if you see, we work, right? We earn, we work in a job. Okay, all of us have job. We earn our income. So if you look at the tube, right? Tube filling with paycheck. Okay, so we have a tube filling with paycheck, and then where we put it into our savings, and after we get our savings, instead of spending to pay the mortgage, instead of spending to pay the car loan, right? What we do is that we convert into asset. We convert into asset, and that asset will generate passive income, right? And when that asset generates passive income, so using that passive income, you pay your expenses. This should be the formula, right? I wish in our schools, this concept was taught to us so that even children nowadays can start thinking about this, right? They may not have the solution today, but as they start thinking now, by the time they reach a particular age, when they start working, before they sign up that particular credit card, before they sign up for a particular personal loan, they will start collecting asset first. Right? They can start collecting asset. Maybe for example, let's say for example, I just completed my degree. I want to start working. And the next thing, thing that usually will happen is that buying a car or buying a house, right? So instead of immediately signing up for a house mortgage or house loan or a car loan, why don't you take a step back and analyze your financial portfolio first? Look at what is your current income. After you have the income, what are your expenses? So with your current savings or with the current balance, what is the way? Is there a way that you can convert these savings into an asset, and from that asset, you generate passive income, right? So that is the way that our young adults should start thinking. Okay, in fact, to my younger siblings, right, I've been started to educating them in this way also. So I hope parents out there or the elder adults, you can start sharing this concept, the concept of pay yourself first, where they can start thinking on how to generate passive income, which they can use it in the long term. Okay, so this is where the concept of pay yourself first is very useful in our financial portfolio. Okay, so yeah, there is the three groups of people who can, who should save gold, because it will be very useful in their financial portfolio, where we first looked at the people who do not have emergency fund. Okay, so instead of keeping emergency fund, the whole of them in the form of cash, you can consider putting them in the form of gold and keep it for long term. Okay, that is one group. Or second group of people where you understand the importance of savings, but because you can only save only little, there is only little allocation. The amount of money that you have per month is rather limited. So what you can do, you can quickly convert 100 ringgit into gap and use the gap as a tool to protect your hard-earned savings. That is the second group of people. And the third group of people is the people who always fall into the trap like me, where I buy things that I actually don't need. Okay, if you look at me, I actually have a lot of things. Before coming across Poppy Gold, I have bought a lot of things which I don't really use it actually. So in order to protect myself against this making impulse purchases, what I will do, I will convert a portion of my money into gap account, into gold, and then I just keep it there. So even if I find a very emergency sales, right, that pair of shoe, limited edition, signed by some celebrity, so what, right? So a shoe is a shoe. But because of this hyped up advertising, you tend to fall into the trap. Okay, so that's where we need to protect ourselves, protect our savings by using gold for long-term savings. Okay, so before I end, I just want to share with you the quotes by my investment mentor. Okay, so in my financial portfolio, I have a couple of tools. So one of them is stock market. So in the stock market, guru is Warren Buffett, where the method that we use in our savings, or the method that we use in our stock investment, is known as value investing, where we find good companies and we study the cash flow, we study the businesses and all that. And there are a few philosophies which tally very same, okay, which actually echo one another. For example, if you look at the second quote over here, where Warren Buffett quote in terms of saving is that if you buy things you do not need, soon you will have to sell things you need. Okay, so I think this is where he's talking about the impulse purchase. Okay, and then if you look at the third one on savings, the quote regarding savings, he said that do not save what is left after spending, but spend what is left after saving. So again, he's talking about the concept of pay yourself first. Okay, and then if you look at the second last, which is on investment, his advice regarding investment is that do not put all eggs in one basket. So he's talking about the concept of diversification. So this is where in our financial portfolio, we must have a couple of tools. Don't put all into one type of tool, but rather you diversify. That is why, again, I started this initiative by the name of Diversify with Gold. Okay, so with that said, thank you so much for your attention. Again, I have that promotion going on, which is going to expire tomorrow. And for 10 people who come in for dinner promotion, I will give you 10 ringgit cashback. And for 10 people who come in for the gold bar, for the 10 gram gold bar promotion, I will give you 20 ringgit cashback, right? So for those who take action, this is my reward to you, okay? So I hope you find this session useful. I will see you again in the next session with another interesting topic. If you have any questions, you can put in the chat box. So far, I don't see any question in the comment section, which is fine. Okay, you can always connect me offline. I'm always available offline. There are so many people actually contacted offline rather than online. Okay, so I totally understand that. So it's okay. You can connect with me and then I will share with you more information. And hopefully, I can help you to start your journey in strengthening your financial portfolio. So, though I'm sitting here alone talking to you guys, but actually behind me, there's a huge team. On my right side, you can see Tuan Zul is there, smiling at you guys. And on my left side, you can see there is this banner known as, there's a banner. Okay, if I just enlarge myself, you can see on my right side, Tuan Zul is there. And then on my left side, you can see a banner with G100 banner, right? So this is the network which I am part of. And I'm using these methods taught by this network to share information or to create awareness regarding savings in the form of gold for our future. So with that said, thank you so much for listening to me. I hope you find this session useful. Ask me questions if you have any, and I hope I will see you again in the next session. With that said, thank you so much. Have a great day ahead. Bye-bye.